Good afternoon, my friends. I didn't ask my mother to come here for my speech. Fortunately, she said, I don't understand English. I wasn't about to talk about my mom anyway, but I'm talking about some experiences from my trip. Can you put your hands up if you enjoy traveling?Great, most of us. Thank you very much. A couple of months ago, I had a chance to Africa. It was my first visit to Africa. Poverty and heat was the only impression I had for Africa countries. So with the excitement and not much knowledge, I went to Kenya, an Africa, Eastern Africa country. We spent the first week in the capital of Kenya,Nairobi. We had a very busy week. We visited schools, talking to students and teachers. We visited non-governmental organizations. We also visited some orphanages, which is hosting AIDA's orphans. But the day we were about to leave Nairobi, a young lady, who is a niece of our host, came to me and said,Honey, I have something for you. Saying this, she took out a necklace, put it on my neck, and hugged me. Oh, I love you, honey. Thank you for coming. Wow, what a wonderful creature. Thank you so much. I was surprised, but full of joy. I spent the next day mourning.Almost an hour thinking, what had I done specially for her that she gave me such a present and saying she loves me? Well, not really. She was the one who is doing all the housework for us for our sake. She prepared breakfast and dinner, and she even took my clothes inside the house when it was raining. She even cleaned my shoes.I didn't do anything specially for her. There came a thought. Not. She is the angel coming to tell you that you are loved and your life is precious. My life was once like this, flat, depressed, out of energy. There was a time when my father passed away, when I was 21. There was a time when we had to sell our apartment because we can't afford. There was a time when my mom left. There was a time when I told myself, you have to be strong because you are the older daughter and your sister is still young. There was a time that I felt everything was not relevant and important in my life, and my life is meaningless. There was a time when I thought nothing is possible.However, I didn't stay there for too long. Just like the young Kenyan lady, there were so many angels around me. Some brothers of my father took a step forward to take care of our family, financially and mentally supporting our family. There was friends who were beside me,having their shoulders ready for me to cry on. I had mentors who were willing to listen to me patiently, to talk over all the stubborn and sadness within. All their care and love impulsed me to stand up again on my own feet and makes me believe thatI am loved and cared, and I am able and capable as well to care for others. An Indian friend once told me, an act of kindness people will remember. It often brings people closer to God. Just a small act like the Kenyan hero did to me. I remember all the way from Africa back to Taiwan. And with the commitment, I'm committed my life to care and to love others to the best I can with all my heart. And they also told me, an angel never stands aside just looking around, but they are always ready to open their arms to embrace others. How many angels in your life that you can recognize? When you turn on the TV, especially the news channels, we can see news, enough resentment, enough arguments, quarrels, and fights in our societies. But there is always a room for us to love others, to care for your neighbors and families, and to listen to your friends carefully and deeply. I'm the one who was picked up when I was about to drown. And are you ready to be an angel of other people's lives? And are you willing? Yes, I am. Come as chair.
I know that now I can also be an angel to all and those around me.
真的假的？
刚才是韩婷 ，Where are you? Oh, right here. Fellow Toastmasters, could you help me with one question? Are you ready to be an angel? Yes or no?
Yes.
See, that's how effective you are. I'm going to look at your speech, your content, organization, and performance. First of all, content. You use your personal experience to tell the story, to encourage us to be an angel. That was very effective because we all can identify with your story. We all have family members who passed away. We all have sometime in your life feeling that nothing is possible. Great job over there. Great content. Second thing,Great closing. An act of kindness will never be forgotten. Are you ready to be an angel? Are you willing to be an angel? Powerful, powerful closing. For improvement, first, because you have such powerful closing, I would like to use some of the material also in the beginning. Maybe in the beginning, saying something like that, an act of kindness. So that kind of hint that something's coming.And then your speech will be more balanced. Second thing, in the content, you have a turning point. A lot of people helping you to help you overcome. I would like to know the name of that person, maybe a Toastmaster member, and what he did, or what she did. In terms of performance, first thing I admire you is your brave courage. Overcoming that kind of interruption, you did not budge.And keep going and raise your voice. And you also use some materials from our keynote speaker. Great job over there. Second thing, your voice. Clear, precise. I follow your story all the way through. And your smile. I was drawn to you right away and ready to listen to you. Great job over there. And for improvement, I feel that one thing, this is large stage area. You did not use the whole area.And also, you did not really look at someone very closely. You kind of scanning the room. So, to help that, I would like you to ask you to engage with the audience by movement. You walk, you pick up one person and walk. I would like to know what you think. An act of kindness will never be forgotten. Lower your voice, slow down, like what Angela did. Your coaching is so powerful. And then you go pick another person.In another area, you go over there and talk to that person, plan and deliver. Another thing that I think is your prop. Okay, your prop, you were holding your prop too early. That kind of interfere, and you also use your mic. That kind of interfere with your gesture. Probably say that sign until you need it. In summary, it takes a lot of courage to be a test speaker. You've done a wonderful job. With some modification in the content and work on connecting the audience, you'll be a great speaker. Thank you. Content master.
Content chair. Ladies and gentlemen, when I'm listening to Hanty's speech, I cannot help but recall what happened this morning with my father. I blame him for being late to driving me to the train station. I feel so ashamed.Because I now know I'm much more blessed. In Hanty's speech, there are many qualities, and here I would like to share two of them with you. The first one is inspiring content. When we think about angels, we think about a beautiful lady with wings and flowing dress. But Hanty overthrew that image and told us thatA girl she met in Africa, and people who is willing to tell people, they are true angels. The message is strong and powerful. The second quality is confidence. When Hanty delivered her speech, she used her facial expressions and her natural body gestures to tell us that how she feelwhen she had some problem with her personal life, and how she loved and cared for people around her. So we feel that Hanty's true feelings
And that's because she delivered this speech with great confidence. As Toastmasters, we all work hard to improve ourselves. So here, I would like to offer a hint in two of my suggestions. The first one is, add more dimensions to your speech. As you mentioned, how much you appreciate people who help you. So if you could talk a little bit more on how you may return its cares from people to not only your friends, but also people in these societies who need help, tell us your action plans. That will actually empower your speech much more. And my second suggestion for Henry is that, well, as you are holding a very cute soft toy in your hand, of course, that's a very useful part. However, when you deliver your speech, if you could actually put that part aside, and that will make you move much more freely on the stage. So all in all, I would like to thank Henting for sharing this precious experience with me, and I really learned a lot from you. So in your speech, the content is inspiring, and also you deliver it with great confidence. If you could actually add more dimension to your speech, and also feel more freely to put part away, I'm sure you will be a very powerful and persuasive, inspiring speaker. Contest chair.